Philippine president reorganizes the government's maritime security sector as China steps up its aggression. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. signed over the weekend an executive order renaming the National Coast Watch System into the National Maritime Council. It will be tasked to formulate policies and strategies that will safeguard Philippine waters. An official of the National Security Council says the move will also help raise maritime domain awareness in other parts of the country.
Yung kabuang ng buong Pilipinas na po ngayon, ang covered niya. Kasi madalas nakafocus lang tayo sa West Philippine Sea. Mm. Ngunit meron pa tayo mga ibang challenges. For example, yung sa Benham Rise, nasa yes. east side ng ating bansa. Nasa north side natin, sa Batanes, no? Sa south, yung facing Indonesia and Malaysia.
The National Security Council also vowing to exhaust all diplomatic measures to resolve tensions in the West Philippine Sea. Malaya says it is not in the interest of the Philippines or any of its allies and partners for war to happen.
Marami sa ating mga kababayan, akala nila yung counter-response natin or measures natin ay purely military.
For one analyst, the recent incidents of harassment at sea by China may have pushed the Marcos administration to take another step in protecting Filipinos in the West Philippine Sea.
The reason why it was expanded from coastal to maritime council is that because of the series of events that happened this month. And I think the executive order number 57 will help us to uphold the fundamental rights of the Filipinos to live in peace and freedom and free from fear of violence and threat. The imminence of a threat here was highlighted in the new executive order.
Beijing, meanwhile, is shrugging off the Philippines' latest move to boost its maritime security. The Chinese Foreign Ministry stood by Beijing's sweeping claims in the South China Sea and reiterated its opposition to supposed foreign interference in the disputed waters. It also urged Manila to manage the maritime row through negotiations.
Stop instigating foreign forces to intervene in South China Sea affairs and return to the right track of properly managing the situation through negotiation and consultation. We should shoulder our due responsibilities for maintaining peace and stability in the South China Sea.
President Marcos's sister warns a new National Maritime Council is leading the Philippines down a dangerous path. Senator Aimee Marcos says emotion has prevailed in Manila's maritime conflict with Beijing. She insists the country should choose peace instead of opting to be warmongers. Meanwhile, some senators slam former President Rodrigo Duterte's alleged gentleman's agreement with China to remove the BRP Sierra Madre Nayungin Shoal. Senator Riz Ontiveros says Duterte had always put his relationship with China before national interest. She stressed the need to keep the BRP Sierra Madre in Ayungin. Senator Jingo Estrada, however, believes the decision would have gone through a thorough policy-making process. The Metro Manila Development Authority denies its unfinished road repair projects are the cause of heavy traffic after the Holy Week break. According to its chairman, Romando Artes, all the MMDA's scheduled road repairs were completed before 5 a.m. Monday. He said unfinished road works along EDSA belong to Globe Telecom's contractors. Artes says these projects are meant to improve internet services.
40 manholes sa kanilang ginukay, 24 po ang hindi natapos. So 16 lang ang natapos. Nung kausap ko sila kanina, ang marami silang kinakatwiran na totally unacceptable po. Talaga po masasabi natin na makasarili sila. Hindi nila inintindi yung pong traffic na kanila ikokos. In fact, sinita ko nga po sila, iniwan lang pong nakatiwangwang yung mga bukay. Iniwan lang traffic marshals. Wala po talaga.